Hello everyone, in this video we will talk about laboratory diagnosis of Salmonella typhi. Specifically, Salmonella typhi is gram negative, non-sporing, non-capsulated, it is oxidase negative and catalase positive. So it won't produce oxidase enzyme but produce catalase enzyme, and it can produce H2S. It is non-lactose fermenter. Salmonella typhi is motile and it is non-fastidious. It can easily grow without any special nutrients. It will look like something this pink colored gram negative, and they have pili and flagella, so I am drawing it. Now, because of Salmonella typhi, we can suffer from fever, headache, chills, rose spots means rashes on the skin, mainly found on trunk in 30% cases. Also commonly abdominal pain, nausea and vomiting, and many more. Let's talk about the topic, the laboratory diagnosis of Salmonella typhi. We have divided this laboratory diagnosis of Salmonella typhi in 6. First, specimen collection. Second, culture media examination. Third, biochemical test for the identification. Fourth, culture smear microscopy. Fifth, molecular methods. And sixth, typing. We will start with specimen collection. Mainly used specimens are blood, stool and urine. They are collected for the culture media examination, and serum is collected for serological examination. The specimen used and test done is depend on the duration of illness. Suppose in first week of illness, we will do culture examination of blood. We will take bone marrow aspirate, duodenal aspirate. In second and third week of illness, we will take serum and culture both. In for serum examination, we will do antigen detection by Vidal test and antibody detection, and stool and urine culture examination. In fourth week of illness, we will take stool and urine culture examination, and for the carriers, stool and urine culture are taken. Also, serological examination, take serum for detection of antibody to VI antigen, and also Savage culture indirectly. So let's start the second method, culture media. Now, as we know that we are taking specimens of blood, stool, urine, bone marrow aspirate, duodenal aspirate for the culture media. Now let's start with the blood specimen. First, blood culture. We will see that blood culture is the ideal method for diagnosis in first week of enteric fever. We will do centrifugation of blood, and after centrifugation we will found serum and clot. We will use serum for Vidal test and clot for the culture media examination. Clot culture has shown higher isolation rate than the blood culture. Now 20 to 20 ml of blood will directly inject into the blood culture bottles. Suppose we have taken 10 to 20 ml of blood, and now we will inject into the blood culture bottle. Wait, blood culture bottle? Yes, we have both conventional blood culture bottle and automated blood culture bottle. Conventional blood culture bottle include monophasic medium and biphasic medium or Castaneda's medium. Monophasic medium include 50 to 100 ml of brain heart infusion broth, and biphasic Castaneda's medium include 50 to 100 ml of brain heart infusion broth plus brain heart infusion agar slope. Now, these automated blood culture bottle include BACT सी बैकटेक और बैक्ट अलर्ट वट एवर यू प्रोनाउंस. नाउ वी ऑल्सो एड एस पी एस सोडियम पॉली एनिथॉल सल्फोनेट एंड इट इज एडेड एज एंटी कोएगुलेंट एंड इट ऑल्सो काउंटरेक्ट द बैक्टेरिसिडल एक्टिविटी ऑफ ब्लड. Now, after injecting the blood into blood culture bottles, the blood culture bottles are incubated at 37 degrees Celsius. And as we know that Salmonella typhi is non-fastidious, it will grow rapidly within 24 hours. So, we will see the growth of bacteria in this culture, blood culture bottle. Suppose this is monophasic blood culture bottle, including growth. Second is biphasic castinedas, it includes the growth plus agar, and last is automated. You can see the growth. Now let's talk about subculture. From monophasic medium we will do the subculture on blood agar and on McConkie agar. We will see the non-hemolytic colonies here, and on McConkie agar we will see pale colony here because it is non-lactose fermenter. Now again, this is monophasic medium, and from this we will do subculture on blood culture and McConkie agar. Blood culture will show non-hemolytic colony, and on McConkie agar there will be non-lactose fermenter. Biphasic medium is preferred over monophasic. Why? Because just by tilting the bottle, the broth will run over the agar slope, and this is incubated at upright position, so the colony will grow on the agar slant. So we can use the colony directly and there will be no contamination. So this is preferred over the monophasic. Okay, this dark brown show agar, and this the light brown color will show the broth, and the colony on the agar slant will lose. Now this automated is superior than the conventional. Why? Because it monitors the growth once in 15 to 20 minutes, and from this the subculture can be done easily. So if we have taken blood as specimen, we have to do all these procedures. Now let's talk about the second specimen, urine. What about in urine culture? Now this urine seldom become positive because Salmonella shed in urine frequently, although this urine is centrifuged and the deposits will be inoculated on the McConkie agar. And we know the result that Salmonella typhi is non-lactose fermenter, so the colony will be pale. Now the other specimen, stool. In stool culture, as we know that stool contain commensal, so here we will take enrichment broth and selective media. Enrichment broth includes selenite F broth, tetrathionate broth and gram negative broth. Selenite F broth, tetrathionate broth and gram negative broth. Selective media include low selective media and the highly selective media. Low selective media will include McConkie agar, and the highly selective media will include DCA, deoxycholate agar, xylose, lysine deoxycholate, Shigella salmonella agar, hectoin enteric agar and bismuth sulfide medium. We will describe each of them. Now the first, deoxycholate citrate agar, DCA. In DCA culture, it will produce non-lactose fermenting pale colony with the black center. Now the second selective media, XLD, xylose lysine deoxycholate. In this XLD agar, it will produce red colored colonies with black centers. So what? Red color colony with black centers. Now the third, SS agar, also known as Shigella salmonella agar. In this, it will show
colorless colony with black center, but SS agar is orange in color. But the colony will be appear colorless and black in center.
Now the fourth selective media, hecten enteric agar. In this agar, it will show the green color colony with the black in center. We see that mostly Salmonella typhi show black center in their colonies. Now the last bismuth sulfide medium. I'm sorry for this. Okay, so this is used for the isolation of S. typhi from the heavily contaminated specimen, and it will give jet black colored metallic sheen colonies. It is similar to our DCA. If in first week of illness all this culture turn negative, then we will take specimen of bone marrow and duodenal aspirant, also of the pus or the screen scraping of rose spots. Now the next method, culture smear microscopy. As we know that S. typhi is gram negative, non-sporing, non-capsulated and motile, so it will look like this. Now the fourth method, biochemical eye test of identification. ICUT test, indole citrate urease test. It will give indole negative, citrate negative, Salmonella typhi is exception here, and urease negative. The TSI test, triple sugar ion test, we will find that there will be red colored slant, yellow colored blood, but and the H2S is present. So the result are simple, that TSI test will show alkaline acid and the gas is present, but not in Salmonella typhi. There will be presence of H2S, but others Salmonella species like Salmonella paratyphi and Salmonella coleriasis will not produce H2S. Now the MR test, methyl red test, and VP, Voges Proskauer test. Methyl red test is positive, it will change in red color, so it is positive, but VP test is negative, no red color found. Other test is sugar fermentation test. It will ferment glucose, mannitol, maltose and sorbitol. They are fermented. Second test is deoxycarboxylation test. Deoxycarboxylation test. Salmonella typhi only decarboxylate the lysine. So lysine is decarboxylated. Now the slide agglutination test. In slide agglutination test, we will see the antigen antibody clump formation. In Salmonella at genus level, it is agglutinable by polyvalent O antisera, but for Salmonella typhi we have to use specific O9 antisera for agglutination. And as we know that VI antigen will cover up the O antigen, so it will make S. typhi inagglutinable with O antisera. And for the solution, we have to test it with VI antigen. Test typhi with VI antigen or boil it for 60 minutes at 100 degree Celsius, so it will remove VI antigen. Now the last antimicrobial susceptibility test for the resistance, for checking the resistance for better treatment, we will do it on Müller-Hinton agar by disc diffusion method. Now the molecular method of S. typhi, whenever it comes to molecular method, PCR is helpful. And the gene targeted here are flagellin gene, IROB and FLIC.
The last method is typing of Salmonella. As usual, it includes phenotypic method and genotypic method. Phenotypic method include phage typing, and in phage typing there is specific bacteriophage. VI phage 2 is helpful, is used. Second, bacteriocene typing and biotyping, they are absolutely obsolete now, no more in use. The last is antibiogram typing, and they are based on antimicrobial resistant pattern. The genotypic typing include IS200, insertion sequence 200 typing, it is most useful. PFGE, pulse filled gel electrophoresis, ribotyping, PCR, RFLP, and sequence based typing, which is most widely used. Now, the treatment of enteric fever. The currently recommended drugs are as follow. It is third generation cephalosporin, example ceftriaxone, azithromycin, and fluoroquinolones, example ciprofloxacin. The Vidal test and serum antigen antibody detection will be described on next week.